Good morning, my dear students. Hope you all are doing fine. So today we will do chapter number 5 of your civics, that is economic presence of the government. Fine. So let's read the chapter, page number 38. The role of the state in respect of economic decisions depends on the nature of an economy. First of all, I want to tell you that what is the meaning of this chapter? Economic presence of the government means where the government stands in the form, in the manners of finance status. Fine. So how the government is strong according to the finances. Financially, how much government is strong? This is the main idea of the chapter. And what is government doing for all these things? What is the role of the government in doing all these things? Means basically economically strong, how the government is applying the systems. So we'll read it. Let's start. The role of the state in respect of economic decisions depends on the nature of an economy. In a predominantly capitalistic economic, the state provides and maintains the economic framework, and the economic decisions are taken by the buyers and sellers in the market operations within the framework. Basically hota na, hum log bhi kuch saman khareedte hain, bechte hain, so exchange of money hota hai. Khareedne wale ko saman milta hai aur bechne wale ko money milta hai. So both status are being calculated here. So same is happening in the government. In a predominantly socialistic economy, the state is the main decision maker. India has chosen a mixed economy where public sector dominates and state is the only decision maker, and the decisions are taken in the light of social goals and not in the light of private gains. Kisi personal ek individual ke liye nahi hota hai, it is basically for the whole society. On the other hand, there is a large private sector in which the factors of supply and demand are brought together by market mechanism. The decisions in the sectors are taken by the buyers and sellers within the market mechanism through the facts of demand and supply. How much will be the demand? Supply is dependent on that only. The Indian Constitution embodies the goal of socialistic pattern of society, which provide necessary guidelines to the government for working in relation to the economy. These guidelines determine the extent of government responsibility in supervising, directing and controlling the economy. Therefore, the power of the government must be used for the general welfare of the people. The guidelines for the working of the economy are provided through the directive principles of state policies. Fine. So we'll read it. Now we have to read that what is the role of the government? What is government doing to make the economic strong? First step is improvement in the standard of living. The economic policy of the government should be directed towards providing better food, clothing, housing, etc. to its people, or to say the living standard should be better and improved. For example, if the citizens of a country are getting good food, good clothes, so it automatically it shows the progress of the country, development of the country. So the living standard of the people should be better. The living standard of the people will be better only when the per capita income increases. Generally, in undeveloped and underdeveloped countries, the per capita income is low, which can only be increased by economic development. Various measures have been taken by the Indian government for the development of different economic sectors like agriculture, industry, trade, transport, commerce and infrastructures. So basically there is a question, per capita income. What do you mean by per capita income? Per capita income is basically there is an average income. Suppose there are 150-130 crore people in the country. So average income of every person basically. some are earning in good amount, some are earning in low amount, but it should be, there is an average amount of every people that has been divided the total income with the total people, and there will be an average amount. The per capita income is calculated like that. This is called per capita income, in how much amount, how much money is being earned by a person. Next is employment. Unemployment is a kind of wastage of manpower. Suppose there are many, like huge population is there in the country, but there is no work for them. So it means their manpower is being wasted here. If the unemployed workers are put to work, they will produce goods or services that will benefit the worker himself as well as the nation. Thus, the government is making sincere efforts to provide enough and adequate employment to the unemployed. The Government of India has undertaken many special programs to generate employment opportunities. They are Swarn Jayanti Gram Savrojgar Yojana, National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, etc. The government is running these kind of policies so that everyone can get the employment. Next point is point third, public facilities. The facilities like electricity, transport, banks, schools, hospitals, which are shared by many people, are known as public facilities. Suppose we are using bus, we are using school, it is not a basically facility for one only, this is for public. To provide public facilities is the most important function of the government. Most of the public facilities are based on no profit, no loss. So private companies do not invest in these facilities. Though many private companies are providing public facilities, but they charge a very high price for these. For example, there is a government school and there is a private school. So we can see the difference in their fees also. So the government school basically are for the purpose to education for all. Fine. So in private school we are finding it better, that we are finding better qualities there, better education there. So, and that's why we are paying extra amount for that, we are paying heavy amount for that. And in government schools, because basically the government schools are on no profit, no loss conditions, so that's why they are not charging as much as the private schools are charging. So basically private companies normally does not invest in these facilities. So though many private companies are providing public facilities, but they charge a very high price for these, as I have told you in the example. Clearly, this is not a desirable option. Public facilities relate to people's basic needs. Any modern society requires that these facilities are provided so that people's basic needs are met. The right to life that the Constitution guarantees is for all persons living in the country. The responsibility to provide public facilities therefore must be that of the government. Next point is the rapid industrialization. The industrialization, it is being increasing day by day. The participation and the support of the government affects the process of industrialization in less developed countries. For strong industries base, establishment of the iron and steel industries, heavy chemicals industries is must, but as this requires huge investment and have long gestation period, the private investors do not come forward to take up such projects. Therefore, the development of such basic industries depends upon the initiative taken by the government. Like if the government wants the development, so government have to take some initiative. So what are the initiative? The government of India is extending its support to the industrial sectors by points are there, you can read the points. First is creating proper transport and communication facilities. So jo government hai वो क्या कर रही है एक्सटेंड करने के लिए अपना सपोर्ट इंडस्ट्रीज़ को कैसे दे रही है इट इज़ क्रिएटिंग प्रॉपर ट्रांसपोर्ट कि अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट अगर होगा तो ऑब्वियसली कोई भी इंडस्ट्रीज जो है वो ग्रो करेगी सेकंड वी हैव एडिक्वेट सप्लाई ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशनल क्रेडिट setting up of power projects, establishing technical and management institutions, providing tax concessions to export units, etc. By establishing various specialized financial institutions like IFCI, IDBI, etc., the government has also provided infrastructural facilities to the industrial sector like transport and communication, distribution of power, etc. Fine. So if the government wants the extension of the industries, industrialization, so government is giving these kind of support to the sectors. Next point, we have sound banking and currency system. If we'll be having the adequate supply of money, then obviously we will get the profits and the progress. The entire economic activity and progress is related to the money and currency system. The banks also mobilized and saving of the people, which in turn are invested for further capital formation. The government has to make all possible efforts to establish and maintain a good currency and efficient banking system. Next point we have, you can see the picture, there is a picture. The Reserve Bank of India is the Central Bank of India, establishing on April 1, 1935 during the British Raj, in accordance with the provisions of the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. RBI bhi bolte hain Reserve Bank of India ko. It is a Central Bank of India. You can see a stamp, a notes hote hain na, currency hoti hai. Mere paas jaise 100 ka note, 500 ka note hai. Aap kabhi dekhenge to uspe ek bank ki stamp hoti hai. RBI bank jo hai wo uska process basically uske under rehta hai ye sara. Fine, next we have economic planning. Economic planning means the allocation of limited resources among different uses in which a way as to bring about the maximum welfare of the people. Means to utilize the limited resources between the large mass. In India, economic planning is carried out by the Niti Aayog. In next part, we will read about Niti Aayog.